I'm Sagil Yao. I'm the founder and CEO of Tonkin.
Stuart Sopp. I'm the CEO and founder of Current.
I'm Jonathan Siddharth, CEO and co-founder of Turing.
It is a very unique creative process to build something from scratch.
This is not easy, like building something from the ground up.
The learnings are all about how you build something from nothing where you have no right and no privilege, and how you keep the momentum and how you don't make a serious misstep, which will actually bring the whole thing down like a house of cards.
But of the fact that there are so many ways to fail, you can fail the culture, you can fail the business, you can fail with the product.
We had to get contracts deployed, and we had to get, before that, auditing done. And a whole bunch of things had to come together technically and logistically, and my MacBook Pro died.
And we just got hammered. That was like a Sunday morning at 7 a.m. and it was all hands on deck for many days as we kind of put out the fire.
So most of the day is firefighting suppliers that are not delivering, firefighting employee issues, firefighting customer that are not happy, firefighting satellite issues in orbits.
And I think I came home that day from the office and told Anna, I think we've done it. You know, I think we really have cracked this. We're going to build a gigantic company. And then I got a phone call.
Everybody's got a great business idea. Everybody. And there's a long list of people that say, oh, you know, I thought of that idea. Like, you know how so-and-so did X? Like, I thought that would be a great idea. It's like, well, why didn't you execute that business? Because it's hard, right? You have to convince people to join the company. You have to find financing. You have to sell your first customers. You have to, you know, take out a second mortgage on your house. You have to go out without a salary. Like, these things are very real.
I'm Andrew Feldman. I am one of the founders and I'm CEO at Cerebra Systems.
I'm Zach. I'm the CEO and founder of Seal.
I'm Ashutosh Garg. I'm the CEO, co-founder at Hateful.ai.
I always had the itch to build stuff ever since I was pretty young.
You can talk to my sixth grade computer science teacher, Mrs. Lundgren, who will tell you I told her I was going to start a company one day and be an entrepreneur.
I had to do this. It's like been in my bones. I've been, dreaming about it since I was a kid.
I built my first computer when I was in eighth grade.
I was the oldest kid on a block of like 15 kids. So I took $2, walked to the drugstore, bought candy, brought it back, marked it up like 1,000,000% and sold it to all the kids.
I remember a very tough programming puzzle that was given to us. And I spent literally 5 days straight, some of them without going to sleep, to solve it. And I was the only person in the class that was able to solve it.
So I'm a founder, I think, for the same reason that I'm an engineer. I just always was a tinkerer. You know, I think as soon as I started coding when I was in high school, I always had like some side project, something that I thought was going to be, you know, the next Microsoft or Google.
My name is Enrique Allen. I'm one of the co-founders of Designer Fund.
So my name is Ville Tuulas. And I work for Outer Bounds.
My name is Pierre Damien. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Loft Orbital.
Nothing that was important or valuable was built in sort of a 9-to-5 schedule.
Probably working still, pretty hard, 80 hours per week, probably.
Being a founder is a full-time thing, right? Like, it's you don't turn off.
During my fundraise for the pre-seeds, I graduated Stanford in June, and I also was pregnant at the time, so I gave birth literally a day after graduation. And I remember like doing like investor pitches when like my daughter Emma was like 5 days old,
and I was like, shit, this is bad. You know, my parents weirdly lived 3 hours north of Wuhan, so I got a bit of an inside track of what was going on. You know, then we sent the whole company home in the first week of March. Then I'm fundraising, right? And now I'm fundraising, and my baby's due in like 6 weeks, and so my wife's like panicking, right? And the hospital's saying, you know, this full of dead bodies. There's 1,000 people dying a day. So there's all this personal pressure. There's this societal pressure. My daughter's now in a country that closes their borders. If you can get in for 2 years, she couldn't leave for 2 years. And I'm just worrying about all these people that work at Current. So if you want to talk about stress.
When it became clear we weren't going to be able to close the Series A with shelter in place going into effect and everything else, I very clearly remember going out onto the balcony, and we had some old plates
And my wife was actually very supportive. We just like smashed some plates to just vent like the stress and frustration.
The impact it has on your marriage or your outside relationships. That for me anyway, to do this job is all consuming. You wake up and you check your mail and thinking about how to improve your company when you're in the shower.
So when I started the company, I had a lot of cash in the bank. I had no financial worries. I had two homes. Now I'm sort of in my late 40s. I no longer own a home. I have no money. I have no financial security, and I don't have the ability to invest in sort of things that my family and friends would benefit from. Because it's all tied up in the company.
Sometimes it's just a pressure test on your soul.
I'm Brendan Eich. I'm the founder and CEO of Brave Software.
I'm George, and I'm the founder of BioPark Health.
Brian Hamilton, co-founder and CEO at One.
The future of the world is where enterprises are going to succeed or fail, not because they have the best technology, not because they have access to capital, but because they have access to talent. And 8-Fold is going to unlock it for them.
Our mission has always been to democratize these really powerful tools and make them available to everybody.
You know, we set out to build a new type of machine that would transform the compute landscape and enable AI to solve problems that are of societal impact.
We see a very specific way where we can build a completely new a line of products from scratch using new technologies.
I think about opportunities that are given to women and how we are looked at in society, and I want to change that.
I think we make a difference in the financial lives of tens of millions of people, if not hundreds of millions of people. And even if that's a few hundred dollars a year that you save them.
It really makes infinite computing accessible to anyone from everywhere.
The world is different because we're fundamentally enabling any organization in the world to reuse space assets. The same way you and I have a video conversation right now, and none of us know how to build a server, how to write FPGA code.
And then when you step back, you're like actually making a difference, actually affecting, you know, Americans' lives. We have 3.7 million Americans signed up. It's insane. It's crazy. It's like a country in Europe. So it's like, you get to affect the outcome instead of just being part of the efficiency mechanism. You can't really replicate that. It's awesome.
There's amazing people all over the world, and it's a shame that for most people, their ability to contribute is impacted by the jobs that happen to be within driving distance, right? We are imagining a future where we take Silicon Valley and spread it all over the planet.
I'm originally from Finland.
I mentioned I grew up in a small town in India.
I was born in China.
I was born in Pittsburgh.
I am originally from Israel. I was born in Jerusalem.
I grew up on an island outside of Seattle.
Grew up in India in past life.
I'm from Ireland, Northern Ireland.
I grew up in Maryland.
So I grew up in the north suburbs of Chicago.
So I grew up in Chennai in India.
I was born in Romania.
I grew up in Oregon.
I grew up in the northern part of Israel.
So I grew up in Houston, Texas, son of immigrants.
And so we lived on military bases. So I lived in Germany, Holland, England, Scotland, Wales.
And I grew up in Carmel.
So I was born in India, but I lived the first 7 years of my life in Indonesia.
So I was born in Chennai, India.
I grew up on the Stanford campus.
I was born in Odessa, Ukraine.
I think about it as like my love letter to the world. It's kind of what you're leaving behind.
Not many people can go tackle these big problems. But if you think you can do it, then you should.
There are always people who will tear you down. So you shouldn't tear yourself down. You should believe in yourself. You're a child of God, you have unique talents and gifts to give. So focus on how you can best give those gifts and what you can do that's good.
If you believe you can, or if you believe you cannot, you are right.
As long as you just try to solve a real problem that you identify and you constantly check in to see if you're actually solving this problem or a different problem, you will be useful at the end.
Would your mother be proud? It's the only question you need to ask.
You know, if you like building things, there is really no better, like there is really no alternative. It's inventing on steroids.
I just love the competition aspect of it. Like startups are, you either live or you die. And so you're kind of always on this edge.
I really am excited to start a company as a vehicle in order to do that, in order to just try and make a billion people's lives a little bit better every day. Like I'm like so excited about it. It keeps me up at night. It's what wakes me up in the morning. When I surf on the weekends, it's where I'm thinking about, like, I want it.
So first of all, I'm kind of pinching myself every day right now. Of like, I'm so happy to be where we are. And, you know, we are really fundamentally helping thousands of people today. And it does feel like the opportunity is there for us to be helping, you know, millions tomorrow.
Look at my background, like think from where I came, right? Like I didn't know what any of this was. Like for me, like, you know, I'm living my dream, to be honest. So everything is amazing. Like, you know what I mean? Like I cannot complain. I really have nothing to complain.
Getting up every day and doing it. That's the best part. You know, it's not, I don't, you know, I'm not beholden to anybody to sort of make decisions. You know, I've structured my life to sort of dedicate, you know, it's turning out to be, I thought it was going to be half a decade, it's going to be the best part of a decade, to doing something which, you know, I think is significant, will have an impact in the world, and I can look back and say, I did that.
I'm Nick Solman. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Beeson.
I'm Anjal Shah, and I'm the co-founder and CEO of Health IQ.
My name is George Netscher. I'm the CEO and founder of Safely You.
I'm Anatoly Yakovenko. I am a co-founder of Solana Labs.
My name is Aparna. I am the founder of Arise.
My name is Lexi, and I'm a founder.
This is the world we need.